My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us a beautiful deen, Islam. One of the special aspects of this deen is good character, morality. The good human nature Allah had created us with to preserve it. And one of this good character, good moral, which will keep us in morality, it will be preserved, that is al-haya. That is the shyness and modesty. It is a natural shield, a gift of our Creator, God, Allah, given to us to make ourselves away from many immorality, from committing many sins. If we preserve our haya, our shyness, our modesty, that will help us, that we don't go to very low level. We can preserve our personality, the beautiful family values Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to us. We can see nowadays the modern society moving away from natural fitra, from good values, family values. One of the most important good values is the shyness, which is a natural shield from committing many immoralities and many sins. And the modern day society's trend is to go towards immorality, promiscuity, and perversion. All these are coming in many forms. A big challenge. How to preserve this beautiful gift of the God in us, in our family, in our children. And Islam has given so much importance to preserve this al-haya, how valuable it is. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that al-haya'u shu'batu min al-iman, wala imana liman la haya'a lahu. The shyness is a branch of iman, the modesty is a branch of iman. And the one who has no shyness, his iman will come to zero level. The less one has shyness, the less one's iman is, faith is. The more one is shy, one's iman could be stronger. And this shyness will be barrier between you and many immoralities. And many of the ahadith encourages us. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-imanu fil jannah wal-bada'u min al-jafa' wal-jafa'u fil nar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, modesty is part of faith, and faith will be in paradise in Jannah. وَالْبَذَاءُ مِنَ الْجَفَاءُ وَالْجَفَاءُ فِي النَّارِ. And obscenity in speech is part of harshness, and harshness will be in hell, in Jahannam. He also said, مَا كَانَ الْفُحُشُ فِي شَيْءٍ قَطُّ إِلَّا شَانَهُ وَلَا كَانَ الْحَيَاءُ فِي شَيْءٍ قَطُّ إِلَّا زَانَهُ. There is never any obscenity in a thing, but it makes it bad. And there is never any modesty in a thing, but it beautifies it. So, and in another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-haya'u khayrun kulluhu." In another hadith, "Al-haya'u la ya'ti illa bil khayr." So, the shyness, the modesty, is good. All of it, nothing bad in the modesty. Always it brings goodness. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu narrates in a hadith, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marra ala rajulin min al-ansar wa huwa ya'idhu akhahu fil haya. The Messenger of Allah passed by a man of the Ansar who was admonishing his brother regarding shyness, blaming him, criticizing him, you are too shy. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ دَعْهُ فَإِنَ الْحَيَاءَ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, leave him alone, for modesty or shyness is a part of iman. In another hadith he said, al-haya'u wal-imanu qurina jami'an, fa'idha rufi'a ahaduhuma rufi'a al-akhar. Modesty and belief are together. Modesty and faith are together. If one of them is removed, the other is removed straight away. He also said, إِنَّ مِمَّا أَدْرَكَ النَّاسُ مِنْ كَلَامِ النُّبُوَّةِ الْأُولَىٰ إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْمَ مَا شِئْتَ one of the admonitions of the previous prophets, which has been conveyed to the people even after the prophet's generation, is that if you have no modesty, you can do whatever you like. That's why the preserving the modesty and shyness is a very important in our deen, in our life, in our family's life, in our children's life. That is a big task upon us. There are huge challenges to take modesty away in the modern day society. The society is heading to that direction. And one of these is to have good dress, to cover yourself in a better way with a better dress. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna Allah ta'ala hayyun sittirun yuhibbul haya was-sitr. Fa idha iktasala ahadukum falyastatir." Allah is characterized by modesty and concealment. So when any of you washes, goes for shower, he should conceal himself, not fully, nude. Cover yourself with at least with a short piece of cloth. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like from us, even in shower time. Musa alayhi salam was so shy. Inna Musa kana rajulan sittiran la yura min jaldihi shay istihya'an minhu. Min Allah. Musa alayhi salam was a shy person and used to cover his body completely because of his extensive shyness. The same thing said about Uthman radiallahu anhu. When he's alone at his own room, he'll not uncover his body as much as possible to cover, even with a loose kind of garment, because he knows preserving the shyness, preserving the modesty is better for his deen and iman. Umar radiallahu anhu said, "Man qalla haya'uhu qalla war'uhu, wa man qalla war'uhu mata qalbuhu." Whose haya is less, his taqwa will be less. And whose taqwa is less, his heart will be dead. Adr ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, "Man la yastahi min al-nas, la yastahi min Allah." If anybody is not, modest from the people, shy from the people, he'll be not shy from Allah. He will be committing anything, any kind of sin. So how we preserve this beautiful asset in ourselves, in our children, and that is some guideline in the Sharia. First of all, to give them a good dress covering their body. We buy for them the clothes, boys and girls, which is appropriate for them according to our Islamic teaching from even earlier stage of the life. And also when they reach the age 10, فَرْضِقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ فِي الْمَضَاجِعِ. We don't make them sleep, the boys and girls, together in the same bed. In separate bed, if possible, separate room. If not in the same bed, if needed, then single bed, two beds, not one big bed, two are sharing. If they are obliged to share, then at least two different blankets, not on the same blanket. All this guideline to preserve their shyness. And also nowadays, we need to have watch our children, because in their hand, internet, there is internet available, social media, mobile phone. This is a big tool, big network of shaitan, all nudity, and all these, which is will be taking away their shyness, all are available very easily, just pressing a button. So we need to watch for this, we need to watchful, we need to be very careful about this amana and responsibility. Most importantly, nowadays, the sex education, when it is introduced in even primary school to secondary school, all levels, this is another problem, challenge to the morality, to the modesty. This is the biggest challenge nowadays. So there are some kind of room nowadays still available that if you can go to the school to tell that what time is the sex education class, I don't want to see my child is attending, I withdraw the child. This is still available, this right. But very soon this right will be taken away from your hand. And head teacher will say no. Head teacher could say, no, you're not allowed. The right will be given to the head teacher. And you have still right to see what material they're teaching. You can challenge them. I need to see what will be taught in the class, the material. Some of the material is very bad. You cannot imagine that your children is attending this kind of classes. So government having had some consultation, having another one, now deadline is 7th of November. If you go online, you know, participation in this consultation, you can contribute to preserve some of these good things, the human values for our children. But we need to also aware when we send our children to school, we ask them, what is this subject, how it teaches? I'd like to get my right. I would like to withdraw. I'd like to see the material. All these, we can have still this right, and we need to get more and not taken this right away from us. So there are, nowadays it is parents' right, but it will be given to head teachers the right to veto paternal request to withdraw. The guidance is hugely vague and allows teachers to interpret its requirements. It undermines the right of parents to decide when and how to impart sensitive information on sexual matters. It encourages children to experiment with and question their biological sex under the gender agenda. Many other things, which is very, very alarming. So please try to contribute. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and preserve our children from all this kind of immorality may they are, you know, vulnerable to. Abillahi tawfiq. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikr al-hakim wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimina min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu wa atubu ilayhi innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.